time, we have to extract the broken part of the bolt. Let's go underneath and take a closer look. And over here, as you can see, I marked it yesterday. 1, 2, 3, 4. And those bolts, well, they're part of the bolts are still there inside. Let me get a camera. You can see where are those parts of the bolts. One, you can see two, three, and four. Yeah, that's what we have. Yeah, this is our work for today. Yeah, in a few minutes, I'm going to show you how to extract that broken part. You can see that bolt goes like that. Here's a spacer, metal bushing, and those bolts are go around. If I'm correct, there's a 32 bolts. This is the upper bearing racer. There's the bottom. There's a slew ring top. Slew ring bearing gear, ring gear is inside. The pivot spins the bearing and house can rotate. Yeah, that's our main thing. And in this video, we'll focus on extracting broken bolts. Yeah, it will be fun.
Nope, unfortunately, I cannot get access to the bolts from inside. No, it's not going to happen. Oof, pretty dirty. No luck. All right, it is what it is.
As example, today we are working on True Color John Deere. Yeah, hydraulic road builder excavator, and we have 2054. Wow, 14,721.5 hours. That's quite a bit. Well, ring gear bolts, they're known to break over time. They experience lots of stress, lots of side force, axis force, lots of tension, and they snapped. And as you can see here, here's a good example. Here's the bolt going all the way through the upper racer into the housing, and here's the end of the bolt itself is 6.25 inches long, and only 1 inch is holding the upper racer to the housing. Only that much. Yeah. There's a one bolt I was lucky to take it out without snapping, breaking. And as you can see here, let me turn my flasher on. As you can see here, there's a crack. It's almost snapped. And if you go and torque those bolts, this will definitely will break. Yeah, we'll end up in a situation like this, where you can see where the line or the bolt is waiting to snap. Well, we cannot go and retorque all those bolts. We have to replace all of them, one out and a new one in. If it's not an option anymore to go and torque them, because they will fail.
In a few minutes, we'll get back to our excavator and we'll start extracting broken slew ring gear bolts. But we're at the shop, pretty quiet, pretty easy for me to explain our technique, how we're going to extract the broken slew ring bolts. As you can see, this bolt I was lucky to get out, and it's almost snapped, and that much of the bolt actually goes into the upper slew ring bearing racer. And let's breaking it off. Here we go. And we have four bolts to extract for broken bolts. First, we need a metal round pipe, same diameter as our bolt, as you can see. They are the same, and this pipe is 3/4 of an inch, same as our bolt. In your situation, diameter can be different. This is a broken part of the bolt stuck inside the house. You cannot see it, it's just broken inside. What we're going to do, I'm going to grab our pipe with a vice grips like that, then get it all the way in. If you need it, you can even tap it with a hammer. Make sure you have a good contact with a broken part of the bolt and pipe, has no any air gap. Make sure it's all tight. Then you go with an electrode. I will show you what welding settings to run and what kind of electrode to use in a few minutes. Now we'll focus on the welding technique and how to actually get that broken part of the bolt out, because at this side won't be easy for me to tell. Will be lots of noise and we'll be doing the job. Okay, then you grab electrode, you bend it 90 degrees, because there's not enough room to get with the electrode all the way up straight. Fortunately, we'll be only using that much the electrode. You probably will go through the half a pack, depends how many broken bolts do you have. Okay, you have a pipe all the way to the bolt inside, and then you start tacking. Go on one side, I will just lift it for demonstration purposes. You go and tack it on one side, then go try to tilt it like this, for example. Go on another side, an opposite side, for example, if it is 3, you go 9, then you try to move to another side like that, go 12 and 6. You don't want to run solid bead, because you might overheat the pipe and burn the hole, and this pipe will get welded to the eraser, or even worst case scenario, you might weld the part of the broken bolt to the eraser itself and won't come out. Might happen sometimes, there's no guarantee. Okay, then you have your pipe welded to the broken bolt, and you go and try to feel it if it's solid or not, firm, and turn counterclockwise. And if everything was done right, your weld is good, it had a good penetration, this part will come out. We'll show you. We'll get to the machine, you will see everything, how it works. Sometimes it's a little bit hard to turn with a vice grip. You just go and weld a nut. Whatever you have, just, whatever right diameter you have, just tack it a few sides, and then just use a adjustable crescent wrench or go and use the socket or open wrench. That way you can use more leverage to turn. Will tell you from the experience, they're not very tight. Usually those broken parts, they come out pretty easy, I wouldn't say, relatively easy. Another scenario, you keep welding your pipe and it keeps snapping, breaking, you cannot get it out. It might happen. It's always a hit and miss. What do you do? First, you pull the pipe out. You'll have the burn rough edge, go and chop it, make sure you have a nice straight flush cut. Okay, so splashing, some welds. Will be hard to make the good contact. Pipe might go like this, and we have an air gap, hard to fill, then it will keep breaking. Then you have to go with the burr. And grind whatever's sticking too far. And preventing the pipe having a good contact. And sometimes when the metal gets splashed and you weld slightly this edge to the razor, you have to go around and grind it. Make sure you have a good, nice contact. As you can see here, it's not perfectly even. You have a little bump on one side, a little kind of divot and galley on another side, but relatively flat. Usually not a big of a deal. You can go and grind, but it will usually works quite well. Okay, yeah, you weld it, and if you have a good, nice weld, it will come out. One, two, and three. If it will keep breaking, take a picture with your phone inside the hole where that bolt and see. What's going on? Sometimes if you run it too hot, you just weld a broken bolt to the razor or to the housing. Yeah, that happens, but grind it and try it over again, and it will take a while. Sometimes it can be cream and butter. Okay, after extracting the broken part of the bolt, always good idea to go and chase the threads. We have a M20 bolt with a 2.5 pitch. Yeah, this is our top. Make sure threads are clean and new bolts will go like a cream and butter. If I miss anything or you have any questions, comments, critics, suggestions, put everything down in the comment section below. I don't like to miss any important parts. Better to make a video informative, useful and helpful, easy to follow up, than just cut a corners and just to make a show. Yeah, I think we are good. Let's get back to the site. There's a wind and snow. We'll fire it up a welder. We'll start extracting those broken bolts. Yeah, all settings, everything you will see at the site. And yeah, pretty straightforward. Let's get started.
I have an extractor pipe ready. I cut it to size. As you can see, it's nice and straight. We're using E7018 electrodes, 2.5. I'm going to start with 100 amps. Ground is negative. Don't go too hot. You don't want to burn a hole in a pipe.
If this video is helpful, educational, please put a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel. Very appreciated that.
Finally, now you can see everything in details. Yeah, everything what we were talking about earlier in the video, about the technique how to extract broken ring gear bolts. Yeah, watch it. Yeah, if you have any questions, leave a comment down below. It took almost 4 hours to get those broken bolts extracted. Yeah, from now on, everything pretty much self-explanatory. We're talking about it. Yeah, and yeah, enjoy. I will get back to you in a few minutes.
to get those broken bolts extracted. Yeah, it takes lots of electrodes. Look at that. Yep, that's where it is. You bend, and then you... weld, and then you... yeah. Go to another one, do the same thing.
This one was broken 1, 2, and 3. The new bolts, all good. Yeah, and this guy will attack later. Yeah, as you can see, it's more grinding and seems like it got welded a little bit to the side. Yeah, it's always hit and miss. You need to have some luck and fortune, and even you have 3 of them came out. It's never the rule of thumb then. All will go nice and easy. Well, and over here, as you can see, I have 1, 2, and 3. This one's kind of came out rough a little bit, but I was able to restore the threads, and that bolt didn't cause any grief, and I was able to torque it to required torque specs. And well, it is what it is. I have one more left to do later, but at least we have 31 bolts all replaced with the brand new ones. Yeah. Thank you so much for your time watching this video. Appreciated that, and see you in the next one. Bye-bye.